There has always been darkness, endless darkness. And in that darkness, there was always light. The eternal balance. Gods are the guardians of this harmony. Without the gods, there would be no balance. Without the balance, there would be no life.
The fourth war of the Shroud began without warning, and without mercy.
Slaughter everyone! This world belongs to the Master!
Just as in the wars that came before, valiant warriors mounted their defense.
Let's go.
master of the Shroud, he summons you back into nothingness. Only death and oblivion await you.
Welcome to the Pantheon, the divine fortress, home to the gods. A place powerful enough to bring you back from death, hero. Yes, you did die on that battlefield. The Pantheon is a place where the soul shards of heroes converge into one being. Neither living nor dead, an eternal hero coming down from the heavens by divine mandate. I'm sure you have many questions, and all will be answered in time. But first, I need to show you something. Follow me, hero. This place was created by the gods so they could protect us from the horrors emanating from the Shroud. For centuries, Dabug, Perrin, and Velis, our gods and protectors, stood their vigil from here. They gave mankind the might to drive the demons back, watching over the world from their eternal thrones. But now, in our most desperate hour, the Eternal Thrones are vacant. The gods kept the balance from shifting back to the demons of the Shroud, protecting all the realms of Rod from each major demonic incursion. And so it was for centuries. We do not know what happened to them. But whatever force removed the gods from our realm, it was a power of terrible magnitude. Velis, god of nature, trickster and traveler, no longer does he protect the forests. Perrin, god of thunder and might, his protection and strength are no more. Dabug, god of light and life, the shining beacon of his presence has turned to darkness. This throne belonged to Morana, goddess of death and wisdom, but she perished long ago, and we have a danger far more urgent to deal with. This is the reality we face now, hero. The gods are gone. We must solve the mystery of their disappearance. Our fate depends on it. An ancient item of great power, a weapon left to us by the gods, is somewhere in ancient Mount Igman. You must return from the Pantheon to the land of the living and find it. Your quest begins through the Battle Gate. It will take you back to the realm of the living. Remember, you cannot stay there forever. Your soul must come back to the Pantheon and rejuvenate. Welcome to Igman, the greatest of mountains, a living barrier against the demons of the Shroud. The crucial Igman stronghold is being overrun by demons as we speak. If it falls, we all fall with it. Somewhere within its walls lies an artifact of great power. My hope is that it is a weapon left by the gods before they disappeared. It is up to you to find out. Our ancestors, guided by the gods themselves, built the Igman stronghold to serve as a bastion against the evils from the Shroud. Its mighty wall, the Bedum, withstood three great wars and hundreds of demonic incursions.
Moranas is high.
Thanks for joining the fight, stranger. Usually, it is up to the Vechna Garda, the Igman Guard, to protect the stronghold. But at this desperate hour, even us blacksmiths must fight. On a wave of attackers? Into the fray!
The Vechna Garda have been the stalwart defenders of Igman since the keep was built. They fought off numerous attacks by the demons, and were led by King Fukashin himself against the great dragon of the Shroud.
Yeah.
come fight! We sure smashed those uglies good. But we're far from being safe. Something tells me this is the beginning of the fourth war of the Shroud. Grim times. Ah, either way, thank you for your help, friend.
Behold, a portal stone, part of the heavens made manifest. It will take you back to the Pantheon, where your body and soul can rejuvenate. I shall wait for you there. You can spend only so much time in the mortal realm before you have to return to the Pantheon and replenish your power. The Hero Forge is a place where all the soul shards converge. It's the place a hero of your stature can prepare for battle. Something powerful is hidden in Igman. Perhaps some of the soldiers stationed there know more of its location. The defenders of Igman still need your help, hero. You should go to their aid.
Where'd you go? No matter. It's good to have you here.
I have a feeling these attacks are not random.
In fact, I think I know why the demons are here.
At the heart of Igman's stronghold lies a seemingly bottomless pit. It's been there since the keep was built.
Most people just accept it as one of the many oddities of the place. But I know better. We blacksmiths have always known it to be the location of a mythic artifact.
You there. Captain Mita Snegoron wants to talk to you.
Well met, friend. Since you decided to join us, we should discuss our defenses. I'm afraid these attacks are just the beginning of a full-scale invasion. Another assault so soon! My men and I will hold the eastern wall. You and Ognya head to the upper floor and stop them from striking from the rear. Attack!
I think I know what these beasts are after! Quickly, follow me!
Thank you.
was... some fight. Glad you got that stinker for me. I think I know what they're after. Don't let them take it.
Don't mourn your new friend yet, hero. The power of the Pantheon is a mystical one, and as its champion, you serve as a beacon to the worthy souls of those who die near you. Ognia was brought back to serve just like you. She's already here. In fact, she wants to talk to you urgently.
Dying was a strange experience, but waking up here is something else entirely. I still can't believe it. Sorry I wasn't of more help down there, but perhaps I can aid you in a different way. I don't think those demons attacked the stronghold by accident, nor do I think that old man sent you there without good reason. As I said, there is a bottomless pit in the stronghold. The secret of the pit was a tale told amongst blacksmiths for generations. The pit holds the most powerful tool to prepare us for the upcoming war. The Drevna Kutia.
Drevna! Gah!
I felt the Kutia was near, but I dared not hope. Hero, this could be the one thing that can turn the tide. It could also be our downfall if we don't get to it before the demons. Quickly now. I shall accompany you to the pit. We must retrieve the Drevna Kutia. The Kutia was given to us by the gods themselves, which means it will take powerful magic to get to it. Magic that will surely draw the attention of the demons. We have one shot at this, hero. You must guard me until my chance. Extract the Kutia from the pit.
Let's go.
Sagda Magi Nava Yasagi Tatabu Kovidish Marina Kutia Kuiti Kvati Mana Kutia Mana Kudises Vadi Rasta Magi Nama Yasagi Tatabu Kovidish Marina Kutia Kuiti Kvati Mana Kutia Mana Kudises Vadi Well done, hero. We have it. We have the Drevna Kutia.
All done.
Though I knew it was an Igman, actually being near the Kutia, it's incredible. I've been hearing tales of it since I was a little girl. Never thought I'd see it with my own eyes.
The Drevna Kutia was meant to aid humanity in desperate times, and times don't get more desperate than this. Place it on the pedestal, hero, and let's put it to good use.
Legends were true! It works perfectly! Don't forget to come back here often and improve every piece of your gear if you want to stay mightier than your enemies.
The Kutia will be a great help indeed, but alas, we don't have time to admire shiny armor and sharp weapons. We must put them to use instead. The moment has come for a most deadly adventure, hero. We must find the absent gods. They are our only hope against the Shroud. The battle gate will take you to the south, to Caradol, and from there we shall seek out the light of Dabog, Caradol's patron deity.
Thank you.
The absent gods cannot be found by scrying or prayer. Our best bet is to locate their temples. The voices of the gods echo in their temple halls. Whatever happened to the god of light and life, his temple is our only hope of finding him. Yeah. Caradol was once a bright, sunlit place. The demonic invasions changed that. One should be wary of the shadows here. They no longer hold simple forest beasts and hedge mages.
Bless my eyes, an eager customer! I've been trying to find my way through this godsforsaken place for too long that I have. You look like you could use a potion or two, eh? Wait, what was that noise? Hey, hands off the merchandise! I'm out of here!
nothing is sacred to the foul beasts from beyond the shroud. They seem to hate.
No! Don't! Go away! Out! How kind of you to save the finest merchant this side of Perun's beard. That was quick work, that was. What's that? You came from the Pantheon, you say? The fabled fortress of the gods? Say, friend, can I go there with you? That is one untapped market if there ever was one. What do you mean? I'd have to die first. Well, those mangy things did land a couple of hits on me. Hey, are you also seeing spots?
I need something else to distract me.
I see another ally has arrived with you. I never imagined the Pantheon, a place for fallen heroes, would take someone like Dukat. But I guess a man of his talents could be useful to our quest.
Ah! Ah, I thought I was a goner. So, the home of heroes, eh? This is even better than you described it, that it is. Small but dedicated market, a niche crowd, plenty of potential to grow, and best of all, no one here knows Dukit. Say, what were you doing down there? The Temple of Tabok, you say? I don't know where it is, but I did see some of them cowled folks muttering and praying. They lit lanterns and candles to Tabok, that they did. I can help you find them, at least that I can. But you've got to promise me something. Don't nab any other merchant while you're down there, huh? I don't want any competition up here.